Hi ma, good morning everyone. Today we are discuss the new chapter. Our chapter name is Wave Optics. Now discuss what about the wave optics. So wave optics describes the connection between waves and the rays of light. It deals with the connection between waves. In waves, connection between waves and the rays. Waves and rays of the light. That is nothing but a wave optics. Optics means light. Waves means waves. So wave optics describes the connection between waves and rays of light. That means light waves and light rays. It describes the connection between the light waves and the light rays is nothing but a wave optics. According to wave theory of light, we are observing it is a form of energy which travels through a medium in the form of transverse wave motion. Light having a transverse wave motion. Transverse wave motion means it having refraction and compression or crescent troughs. In transverse motion, we have crescent troughs. So the light is a nature of transverse waves. Transverse waves means the particles propagation is perpendicular to the propagation of the wave, propagation of the light wave. That is nothing but a transverse nature of the light. So wave optics describes the connection between the waves and rays of the light. And according to theory of light, it is a form of energy which travels in the medium in the nature of a transverse nature. This is what about wave optics. So the speed of the light in a medium depends upon the nature of the medium. Everybody knows already. I will tell you what the light is travel in both any medium, both without medium or with medium. So the speed of the light in vacuum we are concerned, that is the speed of the light in vacuum is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second and 3 × 10⁻ centimeters per second. So the speed of the light depends on the, but in case of any medium we are concerned, the speed of the light will be decreases. That means it is not equal to 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. That means it will be changes by depending on the medium. So that is the point. The speed of light in a medium depends upon the nature of the medium. That's why I am saying like that. So in this, the first important points are the condition which allows us to use the principles of the geometry is b square is greater than l lambda. We are considering this condition. We will describe the light will be interfered, diffracted or polarized, that can be mentioned by using this. This is our basic condition. The condition which allows us to use the principles of the geometry is b square is greater than l lambda. Here l is nothing but a distance between the object and the screen, and b is the size of the object interfacing by the light. Lambda is the wavelength of light. So the second point is, what is coherent sources? We are saying that two lights are coherent. What is mean by coherent? Coherent means two light sources are said to be coherent if they emit waves of same frequency which are in phase or certain phase difference. That means if we are observing any two light sources, those are emit this type of waves. These are having same phase or certain phase difference. That means same phase, almost same phase or constant phase difference. That type of sources are nothing but coherent sources. Two light sources are said to be coherent if they emit waves of same frequency which are in phase or having certain phase difference. That type of sources are coherent sources. That means they emit the light waves are having equal phase. That means two waves are in same frequency are having certain phase difference. Phase means it is the state of the system. That is the phase. Describe the state of the system. So next, third point. When two or more waves propagates in a medium simultaneously, then at any point the resultant displacement is equal to the vector sum of the displacement produced by individual waves. This is called principle of superposition. Here the wave displacement can be represented with y. Here we are discussing about the principle of superposition. In case of principle superposition, we have just two waves. The two waves are traveling in a medium simultaneously and they are at any point we are concerned, the resultant displacement will be equal to the sum of the individual displacements of these two waves. Or we are considering more number of waves and the resultant displacement will be equal to the sum of the individual displacements. That means we are considering just two waves. The resultant displacement means capital Y will be equal to individual displacement. Two waves having Y1 is the first wave displacement and Y2 is the second wave displacement. Then Y equal to Y1 plus Y2 is the principle of superposition. That means the resultant displacement will be equal to sum of the individual displacements. Similarly, we are considering more than two, the resultant displacement is Y equal to Y1 plus Y2 plus and so on. Considering n waves, we will get Yn. So, next topic is the diffraction. Here, we are observing what is meant by diffraction. The bending of light ray around the obstacle is nothing but a diffraction of light. That means the light can be traveled in this direction. Here, some obstacle is there. It will be bends at the edges. The light will be bends at the edges of the obstacle is nothing but a diffraction of light. The light will be traveled in this direction. The obstacle will be there. So, the light will be bends at the obstacle and then follow. So, this type of effect is nothing but a diffraction of light. In this diffraction of light, we have two different classes, Fresnel diffraction and the Fraunhofer diffraction. So, what are the difference between Fresnel diffraction and Fraunhofer diffraction means? In case of Fresnel diffraction, the source will be placed at a finite distance. The source will be placed at a some finite distance, some 5 cm, 10 cm. And here we are not using any type of optics. That means there is no use of the lenses. Opticals are required. So, in this the fringes are formed. Fringes means these are the fringes. Different types of fringes are not sharp and well defined. So, in this we are not able to use any optics. So, in this the fringes are not sharp and well defined. So, in this the condition is if b square by l lambda is b square by l will be approximately equal to lambda, we will observe Fresnel diffraction pattern. But in case of Fraunhofer diffraction, the source will be at a infinite distance. The source is at a infinite distance. In this the opticals are used or in the form of a collimating lens and the focusing lens. Collimating lens are used. That means we are using that lens, the formation of image will be controlled by the observer. The type of lenses are the collimating lenses and focusing lenses are required. So, in this the fringes are sharp and well defined fringes. So, in this the condition is if b square is greater less than l lambda, we are observing Fraunhofer diffraction. But Fresnel diffraction b square by l is approximately equal to lambda, we are observing Fresnel diffraction. In case of Fraunhofer diffraction, b square is less than l lambda, we will observe Fraunhofer diffraction. And once again I will repeat it, wave optics. Wave optics is defined by the wave and the rays of the optics. That means the wave, the light waves and the light rays can be explained by using the wave optics. In this, according to the theory of light, light is a form of energy which is in the nature of a transverse nature. It's the speed of the light can be depends upon the medium, can be used medium of the nature of the medium. So, the condition which allows to describe the optics in the by using the condition is b square equal to l lambda. B square is greater than l lambda. Here b is the distance of the object, size of the object. B is the size of the object, l is the length of the distance. Distance between the object and the screen, and lambda is the wavelength of the light. Next, coherent source. If two coherent sources means when two light sources are said to be coherent, if they emit waves of same frequency which are in a phase, when two or more waves are propagates in a medium, at that point the resultant displacement will be equal to the sum of the individual displacement. That principle is nothing but a principle of superposition. And next one is the diffraction. The diffraction means the bending of light ray around its obstacle is nothing but a diffraction. In this diffraction, we have two different classes, Fresnel diffraction and Fraunhofer diffraction. In case of Fresnel diffraction, there is no lens or used. So, the image will not be a well-defined image and not a clear image. No optics are required here. So, in this the condition is b square by l is approximately equal to lambda. We are observing Fresnel diffraction. In case of Fraunhofer diffraction, we are observing by using lenses, optic lenses and collimating and focusing lenses here we are using. So the fringes are sharp and well defined. In this the condition is b square is less than l lambda. Here we are using the Fraunhofer diffraction. Here we are observing the Fraunhofer diffraction. So here collimating lens means the formation of the image can be moving, can be described by the observer, that type of lenses decided by the observer. The type of lenses are nothing but a collimating lenses. Next we will discuss the interference of light.